Hello everybody, I'm the Sonic Hero, and welcome back to Final Fantasy 1 on the PSP. Now, this episode, we're not watching this. We're loading our game. Where were we? Did I save a state? I don't know. Probably not. So we're going through the Mirage Tower. But this episode, We're spicing it up, quite literally. Every time we get into a battle, I will eat a Takis. So, I am a white boy who can handle a little bit of spice. But not much. So every time we get into a battle, I'm eating one. It's gonna be messed up. We're just gonna go through the Mirage Tower, and we're not going to be speeding this up. I gotta eat a Taki already, but I'm explaining the rules. So every time we encounter a battle like this, I eat one Taki. We're not gonna speed up anything except the encounter flash when we encounter something in the overworld. And I'm also not going to speed up the battle. So, what am I doing? Let's just do this. Ow. Bam. Also, I'm not awake by any means. In any sense of the word. So, I have me a Monster Energy Drink. Ultra Red. Probably my favorite kind. Deathbringer. Sword that casts death when used. Red Wizards can use it. How powerful is it? Less powerful than the Kikuchimonji. Kikuichimonji. But it ups evasion and such, so what's it turn into? A diamond helm. Really? A diamond helm. Lowers defense and attack, but ups evasion. Absolutely not. I'm also not speeding anything up because, well, I'm not speeding much up because I need to use more magic, like Thundaga. What am I doing? I could use Dialga. But also because too much capsaicin and sodium will kill you. Or can do so much harm, so that's why I'm hydrating. As well as okay, what did we just get? Vorpal Sword. Sharp Crescent Blade and Shielded Guards Against Stone. Vorpal Sword is here. So 5 down. Flame Shield. The Vorpal Sword turns into a Flame Shield. Well, I got the Aegis Shield. Who can equip it? A Knight. Okay, yep, nope. Can't do that. That's a Taki. I should have mentioned this before, but I'm not sponsored by Takis. Like, there is no way anyone would sponsor me to do this. I'm just doing this for fun. Like, I was gonna do this when I played something. I was gonna play a game, and like every 15 seconds, I was gonna play the Crooked Man, and every 15 seconds I was gonna eat a talkie, but that was stupid. So, yeah, no. Oh, spicy chip funny moments. I hope. A healing helm. Casts heal, doesn't it? Yeah. A knight and a ninja can equip it, so... Next time I play this, I'm picking my own party. That's a talkie. Ow. Ow. I mean, I stand by my statements. Like, they hear all these explosions. Why don't they just stay away? So, word of warning. Never eat so many talkies in a row. Master, we have waited so long. Yeah, a lot of spicy at once can do a lot of damage to you. So just make sure you have something to hydrate yourself nearby. And also, watch the sodium, because that dehydrates you even worse. Makes the symptoms worse. Whew! It's like, talkies are... Like, per serving, talkies are... 18% sodium. Or... Yeah, 420 milligrams per serving. So, just... be careful. That's another... But, ugh, yeah. Spicy things like capsaicin can do real damage to your body. It activates all sorts of receptors throughout your body, called TRPV1. If you've seen Matt Pat do his Imitation Hot Ones video. Then... Just don't recommend it. A lot of spicy is bad. That's why I'm only eating one talkie per thing. Why didn't I do Faraga? Vampires are undead. There we go. See? Yeah! One more. Oh, this was a mistake. That's another. Hello. I'm getting lightheaded. Okay, yeah, for the sake of my physical health, I'm gonna stop for, like, a while. Yeah, I'm stopping for a while. There's a point where physical health is more important than entertainment. If that was even entertaining. I don't know, dude, but... Whew. Yeah, when you get lightheaded, it's time to maybe stop. When my body is back in a state of homeostasis, I'm going to, yeah, well, as soon as my body is back in a state of homeostasis, I'm gonna maybe stop that. I'm supposed to go this way. So we're supposed to be going up, that's right, okay. I forgot that I get lightheaded every time I eat Takis, so... Yeah, I'm a stupid. If doing something makes you lightheaded, you gotta stop for a minute. Thor's hammer, who can equip that? Cast Thundara. Diamond shield, huh. That's one way to... Sunblade. That's one way to, put a diamond shield on something. Sunblade, effective against undead. Okay, and then dragon mail. Only the knight. What does a sunblade turn into? Light robe? Spirit of Light. Nope. Not even worth it. If it can give me substantial gains in terms of just anything, then... Your friend left on a journey to the west. He took the warp cube, went to see our master. Right, I found the warp cube. But yeah, like, I can handle some degree of spice. What was that? A blue dragon. Thunderbolt. Ow. Okay, I'm gonna look up the blue dragon. What does that do? I was seeing if the blue dragon dropped anything, so no, it does not. Okay. Here we go. To the Flying Fortress. Alright. It's not so much the spice that's getting me. Like, that's a degree of good. That's a good degree of, like, spice, but it's the sodium that's the enhancer. Like, oh boy. A razor. Saber that casts Scourge. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. An Aegis Shield? Nah, Sage of Surplus. No. Yeah. So why don't we put an Aegis Shield on a character that can't equip it? Now where am I going? I'm going this way. Maybe. Money. Hello. Oh, Spirit Naga. Protect Ring. Healing Helm. Again? Against instant death. Everyone can use it. Knife. Lust Dagger and Golden Staff. Enhances intelligence. That'd be good for That'd be good for the Black Wizard, but what am I doing? But the white wizard needs to have a higher spirit, because white magic is based on spirit. Evil eye. Money. Potion. Evil eye. Jeez, the Black Knights are everywhere. Cottage Mithril Helm. You know, I would normally let the intrusive thoughts win, but I'm not gonna. Oh, Chimera. Oh. I guess it wasn't a static encounter after all. The Spirit Naga must cast white magic. What is that? Adamantite! Aha! Well, back down. I can use exit. Okay. Easy. Is this adamantite? All right, I'll use this to make you the finest sword you ever wield. Dun, in all my years, I've never crafted a finer sword. Go on, take it. She's yours. Excalibur. Who can equip Excalibur? Not anyone I got! Legendary metal is supposed to be... Oof. You know? Hold on. Well, Excalibur turns into some armor, so... Well, obviously, but, like, an armor slot. But I can't find out... I can't show you unless I have a knight on me. Only knights can wield Excalibur. That's a ripoff. If I had... If I had, like... Oh, what turns into a twist headband? This. If I had... I could get more of these. Like, attack goes down, but accuracy goes way up. If I had twist headbands, I could... I could duplicate this sword onto my two. But I don't, so. Wait a minute. The intrusive thoughts are winning. The intrusive thoughts have won. What turns back? Oh, shoot. It's a power staff. Okay, now I have twist headbands. Okay. Wait. Why did I duplicate these? I read that Thief and Monk and their upgrades can only equip these. What? Ugh. Why am I an idiot? Nah. That's it. I'm retiring. I'm an idiot. What is wrong with me? Like, actually in for cereal. Like, what's wrong with me? You know, I don't think I want the answer to that. I really don't want the answer to that. Simon Gloves, okay. Yeah, next time I'm bringing either a monk or a thief into my party, so... Ugh. Diamond Shield, a ribbon. A knife with a gleaming golden blade. Is that right? Nope. Gigantex, that's right. Black robe, white robe. Cast Invisera, cast Blizzara. Jeez. I'm still a little salty about how stupid I am. From this observation window, you can look out on the entire world. Looks out upon the world, and the four horses of fire, earth, water, wind appear as a mist converging on a single point. Point at the center of the four altars, this must be the location of the Chaos Shrine. Tiamat, no known weakness. No known weakness, huh? I guess Tiamat's the strongest of the four? I don't know. Can't hold any more of those. Money, protect ring. Another one? Nope, hello. Analyzing Tiamat, no known weakness. I mean, Tiamat's the fiend of wind, so I assume Tiamat's weak too. Like, I don't know. Gold Needle, Sasuke's Blade. Just the ninja. I think the ninja can hold double weapons. No, wait, that's not a thing. Not in this game. two, three, four. This goes back to number two. You know what? Hold on just one sec. Okay, I had to look up a map of the fourth floor of the Flying Fortress. Because, jeez, man. Depending where we come out, we can just do one of these and one of these. No! Okay, so we go back this way. This up like this, over like this, or not. The Lich, Merilith, the Kraken, you have defeated three fiends and reached my lofty perch. More the better. May the image of Tiamat, the Fiend of Wind, be the last to burn in your eyes. I was not prepared. Someone's laying an egg outside. Okay, let's see. I need items. Ether. Flare! Ouch. Well, damn it. What's for wind? How much power wind flows north? Okay. Or fourth. Here we go. Now to the Chaos Shrine. And no, I'm not going to fight the optional boss, Death Machine, until I play this game for reals. Probably a good idea to save. I wasn't there before. Do you remember that guy? We talked to him when we were in Cornelia, and he didn't say nothing. May I ask him to see if he's forth from the wall, touch the wall? Yes. Door appeared. Herein lies the labyrinth of time, the dominion of he who roams the myriad eons, master of time. Transcending time and space, the master now occupies the shrine. Ye who have entered this place undoubtedly possess powers worthy of the honor. However, all you have come to know about how the world works will be called into question here. Devices and puzzles designed to test your metal abound within the halls of the labyrinth. Miasma drains the power of those out of time, and monsters soon swarm about the weak. Sacrifice an ability to the light of time beforehand to buy time to keep the miasma at bay. Only by solving the mysteries of each floor can you progress through the labyrinth. There's a tablet near each device and puzzle. Consult the tablet to activate the floor. Those who overcome challenges with time left breaks the blue seal, revealing the path of the proven. Those who proceed after time has run out break the red seal to a place befitting their powers. Goes without saying, there's no turning back. Bear this in mind as you go forth. Here goes. Modern maze, huh? I am the light of time. Those who seek to traverse my halls must first provide me with an offering. In exchange for the power you sacrifice, I offer you the precious gift of time. Ooh. No flea command. Confirm. Very well, be on your way. Move to the next floor. Place is whack. Here you'll find 8 pits and 8 stones. Use them wisely, and the path shall unfold before you. If you push a stone into tight space, you may not be able to free it, so use caution. If you should come to an impasse, speak to an automaton within. Floor's been activated. Here we go. This is what we're doing. What the hell kind of puzzle is this? No! Bastard! Initialize fucking system. You get the hell out of my way. Oh, shit. You! I hate you. Can I just thunder all these guys? I would very much like to thunder these guys. That should do some good damage. Blue Sea has been broken. And just where is it? Time offering, blah blah blah. You know what? No fleet command. No magic command. I'm feeling confident about that. Be on your way. Blah blah blah. Let's go. Yes, let's go. Medieval dungeon. Follow path of light, travel the trail of the light to break the exit seal. Floor's been activated. Oops, that's right. Now I remember, okay. Ding, blue seal's been broken. Where is the seal? Here we go. Medieval dungeon. Lab time. No recovery items. No. Accuracy halved. No dash ability. Let's go. Very well, be on your way. Let's go. Gaia Gear. Buried 18 paces away is the key that will break the seal on the exit. Search for it upon that very ground, and you should be able to dig it up. Unearth the key and break the seal of the exit. Monster. Here. We were getting stacks on stacks on stacks. We're already at max money again. That is insane. Sorry, I just realized I haven't been talking much. I've just been focused. Here we go. Alright, medieval dungeon. Light of time, provide offering, blah, blah, blah. No fight command? Yeah, alright. No item command? No. No white magic? Nope. No recovery items? Okay. No attack items? Oh. I mean, attack halved. Accuracy halved. Be on your way. So, first of all, Judgment Staff. This is how we're cheating around it. All right, now we can medieval dungeon. I'm going back to the talkies. Study the cloud of bats? Okay, so I didn't touch any. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 10, 11, 12, and 3 stationary bats. All right. Original Chaos. Of time, seek traverse, no fight, no flee, no magic. Be on your way. I'm keeping my dash ability. Pair of statues face one another, the path shall unfold before you. Investigate the statues, you will be able to move them about. Should come to an impasse, speak to an automaton within. Floor has been activated, okay. Yes. Sorry about the flashes, everybody. All statues have vanished. Blue seal is broken. Awesome. Well, someone should cheer seal up then. Get it? Blue seal? Kiss from a rose seal? Nah, you're all a bunch of uncultured swine. That's not true. I like you all. Thank you for being here on this video, by the way. I don't know if I've mentioned how grateful I am to you all. So where am I? Next floor. Okay. Well, here we go. Inner Sanctum. Status, HP, and MP restored. Next floor. Netherworld Crypt. Light of Time. No fight. No attack items. No flee. Attack halved. Accuracy halved. Oh, I got 41 minutes to do this. Let's go. Black dragons be tough. Sheesh. Gaia gear. What does that actually do? Earth's Grace, huh? I mean, you can cast Quake. Man, what the hell, boy? These black dragons, slim, thick, got me quaking. Here we go. Set the candles of light to find the exit. Beware the enemy cloaked by lightning and darkness. Compass just in the battle open for you. Beware the omen of the thunderbolt. Lightning will strike 5 paces hence from the omen. Those traversing the corridor when lightning strikes will be swept back here. If you know what's best for you, you'll stay near a lightning rod. Okay. Bzzz. A war mech. Now we're talking. Now we are talking. Direct hit. Lightning rod saved you. So there's the thunder, and then there's the lightning. Got it. Nope. Damn it. Set the candles alight to find the exit. Not. Direct hit, yep. Time's out. Megalixir. The Underminer. How are you even supposed to do this? How do they expect anybody to do this? That's my question. Like, oh my god, I am... Damn it! Yes, reset the damn puzzle! The red seal is broken, for God's sake! At least I think it's broken. Like my psyche! Let me explore around this bitch. It is pooping time. This game is perfect for pooping time, especially on the PSP. Oh my god. Let's go. No fight, no flee, attack halved, accuracy halved. Where's the puzzle? Lucky sevens. Thank you. Silent enemy looms ever closer, mirroring your every move. Work your way around the enemy to reach the exit. Think about each step carefully, mustn't speak to the enemy or even come in contact with the enemy. Blue seal is broken. Here we go. No fight, no attack. Attack halved, accuracy halved. Very well, be on your way. Yes, thank you. Let's go. Oh no, don't tell me. Sage's staff. Cast life. Can be used by mages and wizards, apparently. So I guess it's not a fail condition if I touch the monsters. hell are these other statues? There's the bats. Lucille! Off we go. Let's go. All right, I am going to save state. We are going to end the episode here. This took way too long. I'm sorry. I will be back in another episode. So thank you guys so much for watching. Actually, no, you know what? We're at the end of the game. Status HP MP restored. Okay, they both do the same thing. Here we go. You've done well to come this far. This entire labyrinth is an illusion I created to lure those bearing power such as yours. Know that you now stand before the ruler of countless ages, the Lord of Time. Across the eons, several mighty warriors have stood before me as you do now, all wanting to acquire my powers. And in my labyrinth, I test their minds, weeding the weak out from the strong. Kneel before me, brave souls. I bestow upon you an honor reserved only for the wisest of sages. I offer you the power of time. Indeed, the very power I possess shall be fed by your powers. Chronodia? How much damage does it actually do? A couple of hundred. A couple of hundred of them. Oh, Jesus. How much health does Chronodia have? Hold on, just one sec. Whoops! I was looking at a walkthrough and I forgot to unpause because, well, I guess, having the White Mage equip the Sage's Staff doubles the damage Holy does. Holy shit, I'm sorry. Jeez. Barbarian Sword. Whew! And the flow of time itself, I can come to no end. Oh boy, sorry! Well, yeah. I guess we no longer have the, judgment staff. But, holy shit! Okay! Let's leave the labyrinth. Legendary false god. Lock the time chamber. Save your game, you'll be able to reverse the floors of the labyrinth that you're already beaten and try to clear them all. Okay. Oh, wait. That's right. That was optional. Well, I guess... You focus the light of the four shining crystals on the black crystal. Flow of time surges in the space begins to warp. One step forward, you will travel back 2,000 years in time. Nope, I'm going back out to save. So... Yeah, now I'm ending the episode. I thought that would... Never mind, then. Thank you guys so much for watching. This was a long episode. Next one will be short. So, thank you, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.